listen to see people with their heads up to the sky still. Cause honestly, for the same people, life can be so real.
Hey, greetings to everyone who is tuned in right now. Everyone who's watching this video, everyone who is waiting on the word to come forth in this video, I greet you in the name of Jesus. I'm coming to you because I wanted to really extend what I was talking about this morning in the sermon about being released from things going on in our minds and our hearts and our spirits. And I really wanted to be able to extend, since there was a limited amount of time in which I had to bring forth the word. I really wanted to be able to just give you an extension of what was being talked about. You know, we talked about being that lotus flower. We talked about being able to bloom in the mess of mud. We talked about being able to get out of the muddy mindset and being able to enter into something new, because we have been taught and we have been given the encouragement that our story is not over. As long as God is in it, as long as God is dealing with us, as long as God is keeping us, God is being with us and he's walking with us, our story is not over. So I really wanted to encourage somebody in that. But I also want you to know that you are not alone in the fight that you are going through, whether it be depression, whether it be low self-esteem, whether it be low self-worth. You are not alone in the fight. Not only do you have God with you and God carrying you, but you also should be aware of the fact that there are others who are going through the same things, others that are really going through the same type of emotional roller coasters. And therefore, there's nothing wrong with you. There's nothing bad about you because you are going through. Again, it just means that you are a person who is in need of a release and restoration. So I really want to take out time to talk about somebody in the Bible that really dealt with this sense of depression and really had to figure out a way to get past it, figure out a way to get away from the mindset that he was in. And that person was Elijah. And we look at Elijah's story in 1 Kings, and really the part that he was dealing with, a part that was going on with him dealing with depression, comes in 1 Kings 19. And 1 Kings 19 really gives a depiction and the picture of everything that he was going through at the time, because he was really mentally and emotionally battling something on the inside. And so, you know, the thing about it is that anytime we emotionally and mentally battle something, we should look for God to intervene. We should look for God to come about us. But I encourage you, let me go ahead and give you this. I encourage you to look at 1 Kings 16, 17, and 18 beforehand, because it's really going to see, you really begin to see how the whole atmosphere of Elijah begins to shift from one wave to another, from one point to another. And we begin to see how it really takes a downward spiral. Now, 1 Kings 19, like I said, gives us the picture of Elijah's depression, but he really dealt with this bout of depression, and really to a severe measure. Elijah, as we look at 1 Kings 19 from the New Living Translation Bible, and we're going to start at verse 1. It says that when Ahab got home, he told Jezebel everything Elijah had done, including the way he had killed all the prophets of Baal. So Jezebel sent this message to Elijah: "May the God strike me and even kill me if by this time tomorrow I have not killed you just as you killed them? Elijah was afraid and fled for his life. He went to Beersheba, the town in Judah, and he left his servant there. Then he went on alone into the wilderness, traveling all day. He sat down under a solitary broom tree and prayed that he might die. "I have had enough, Lord," he said. "Take my life, for I am no better than my ancestors who have already died." But watch this, because this is really important here. Then he lay down and slept under the broom tree. But as he was sleeping, an angel touched him and told him, "Get up and eat." He looked around, and there beside his head was some bread baked on hot stones and a jar of water. So he ate and drank and lay down again. Then the angel of the Lord came again and touched him and said, "Get up and eat some more, or the journey ahead will be too much for you." I'm going to stop right there, because right here we see a story of Elijah who was dealing with Jezebel at this time, because Jezebel was set out to really not only put him in a place of making him feel bad for what transpired beforehand, but she really wanted to get him to a place emotionally and mentally and spiritually where he was just ready to just end everything, to end it all. He was ready to give up. He was ready to give in, and he was ready just to say, "I quit. I'm done. I can't deal with it. I can't deal with the pressure. I can't deal with everything that is going on with me mentally right now, feeling guilty about what has happened, feeling guilty about what the events that transpired before him. So let me just end it, because as I deal with it, and as I continue to look at it, then in hindsight, I'm no better than my fathers. I'm no better than the ones who came before me because of what happened with the prophets. Because of the prophets of Baal being killed, then then my hands are just as bad, and my hands are just as dirty as the forefathers that came before me. So because of Jezebel, he fled and he left and went into the wilderness. Now, how many of us know that the enemy is going to try to implant stuff in us to make us feel guilty when we shouldn't be feeling guilty in the first place? He's going to try to take stuff, and he's going to really hone in on certain points of our lives where he's really going to try to take and really try to destroy us from the inside out because of the fact that we are really trying to operate in God. Because of the fact that we are trying to walk in God, the enemy is not pleased. So he's going to try anything he can to stop. So right here, Elijah was a great man of God. He was a great man who walked in God's ways, and Elijah was a great man who, when we look at his story, many things happen up under his watch, but one person comes around, and she takes and she crumbles his sense of worth. She crumbles his sense of being. She crumbles everything that he stood for in God. So Elijah became afraid, and he fled for his life. He fled, and then he decided he was going to lay up under the tree, and that was going to be the end of it. He was going to lay up under the tree, and then he was going to just die. He asked God to take his life away from him. He didn't want to be alive anymore. He didn't want to be a part of anything anymore because of the guilt that was going on so deep inside of him. He was just ready to die. And so at that point, God begins to intervene. He begins to just come in and really intervene by the way of an angel. Because the angel told Elijah, "Okay, you had your pity party. You done had your moment of laying up under the tree. You done had your moment of saying that it's not worth it to live anymore. But now I need you to get up, because there is more that I need you to do. Notice here there was two meals, or two different meals. Number one, the angel told him to get up and eat. And there was bread and water, and so he ate that. And then the angel told him, okay, get up and eat some more, because the journey ahead will be too much for you. So he gave up. He got up. He ate. Got his strength. And not only physical strength, but I believe he got his mental strength back. He got his spiritual strength back. And he went on his journey. What I want to encourage you in this video is this. That you have a journey ahead of you. That you have a journey waiting on you. That you have a journey that is for you, destined for you, and specifically designed for you, that God is wanting you to travel on. And we cannot travel on our journey if we are so consumed with us. We cannot travel on our journey if we're so consumed with what's going on with us. We have to be consumed with God. We have to be consumed with Him and allow ourselves to really think on Him, think about Him, and think about everything that is a representative of Him, His Word. And we begin to really just hone in and on the necessity of prayer, and we begin to walk in His will, and we begin to really take notice to the importance of having Him on our minds day in and day out at all times. So because your journey is ahead of you, because your journey is taking place, you have something waiting on you to complete. You have a destiny ahead of you. You have a purpose to fulfill. Elijah said, I just want to die. I just want to die. And some of us, and some of you, have gotten to a point where you just want to give up. You feel like it's not worth it no more. You feel like it's not even worth fighting the battle no more. But it is worth it, because your story is not over. If you are in the place that Elijah was, then you have to learn to get in the place that Elijah got into after his time of really feeling sorry for himself. I encourage you, get up from up under your tree. Get up from your position of laying down and walk in what God has for you. Because your story is not over. Whether you're going through depression, whether you're going through low self-esteem, whether you're going through low self-worth, your story is not over. Amen. Amen. Listen, I have been blessed to give you this word. I have been blessed, and I pray that it encourages somebody, that it blesses somebody's heart. You are that lotus. You are that flower that blooms in the mud. So let it be so. Listen, I love you. And God loves you. And may God bless you. Peace out. All your strength I am, and I'm grateful you come through, yeah. So I take this time to stop a moment and show my gratitude for you. I put my lighter in the air for you. I see what you're doing, yeah, I see what you go through. Put my lighter in the air, the truth is you're beautiful, 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 beautiful. You light it in the air for us. Everybody singing together, sing a new song. Put your light it in the air for love. It's beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Many mighty ships are sailing.